These are exciting times. We're getting a Star Wars movie every year. And this year's movie is Rogue One, A Star Wars Story. It's basically the first war film in the Star Wars franchise, which I'm really excited about. Something else I'm really excited about are Star Wars games. And Star Wars Battlefront has just celebrated its one-year anniversary, which is really cool. These are two really cool things. And together, they give us news. We've got gameplay details, in-game footage, hero details, and a lot more, including the release date of the Rogue One tie-in DLC for Star Wars Battlefront. Battlefront Rogue One Scarif arrives on December 6th, 10 days before the release of the movie in theaters. The DLC includes four new maps, and it says including the sandy beaches of Scarif, which leads me to believe it may not just contain maps only on Scarif, yet it is called Rogue One Scarif, so are we going to get maps off Scarif, or are all of them going to be on the tropical planet? I wouldn't be surprised if one of the maps takes place on Jedha, although that's very unlikely. It's more likely that they're referencing one of the maps that takes place in space over Scarif. What I'm about to talk about are my theories on the game mode in Rogue One and the battle in the movie that it mirrors. Whether the game mode is space to ground or ground to space, either order, these theories work. You just have to shift around the order a little bit. However, I think their vague wording on space to ground, ground to space is vague on purpose, because I think they're trying to throw us off. But anyway, what's really interesting about this game mode is it kind of gives more insight into my theory on Rogue One and the timeline and layout of the film. I believe that Scarif takes place at the very end of the film. It's the last battle, if you will. They're stealing the plans for the Death Star. Director Orson Krennic is getting awfully nervous. Jyn Erso, Captain Cassian Andor are on their way to infiltrate the base, the space tower of Babylon, if you will, that will lead them up into space. It seems that throughout the entire movie, they've been following this orange shipping container crate, all the way from Jedha to Scarif, the crate's final destination. I believe that the ground battle is going to be Chirrut Emwe and Baze Malbus's push on the base with a bunch of Rebel soldiers, which looks like we got some Rebel soldier skins in this DLC, which is awesome, and you're going to be facing off against AT-ATs. I don't think you're going to be facing off against AT-ACTs because we do see AT-ACTs in the background, but it looks like it's mainly going to be Walker Assault versus an AT-AT because I don't see any in the footage, and a regular AT-AT is in the forefront. I'm going to say the AT-ACT cargo variation is instead going to be a set piece in the background or off to the side. I'm not sure if the new U-Wing vehicle is going to be pilotable in this DLC. It may just be a support pickup, but if it is pilotable, I don't think it's going to be available in the space battle. I think it's going to be available as a flyable ground support type vehicle because it is a combat transport vessel. It's a bit like a Huey helicopter in a way. Both doors on either side can open up, revealing big, bad blaster cannons that can be fired out of either side. And I think that's awesome. I'm really excited about this, especially if it is a ground support vehicle that's flyable by a human being, and both gunnery positions are controllable by human beings. We don't know exactly how many stages are going to be present in this game mode. I'm assuming it's going to be two because they mentioned ground and space, but there could definitely be three or even four. If there are two, the second stage is going to be space, like this clip that we saw in the trailer. I believe that this Space Odyssey 2001 looking structure is a part of this vast military installation on Scarif. It's like some sort of a space construction tower. There was a Lego set that was leaked, and it was basically an assault on some sort of a deflector shield generator, which is heavily defended. So I'm going to guess that it's also going to have something to do with taking down the supposedly impenetrable deflector shields surrounding Scarif. As far as skins go, it looks like we're getting some Rebellion skins, maybe even an alien, one of the new aliens that we see in Rogue One. And as for the Empire, we're getting Shore Troopers. It looks like we're getting the normal variant and also the secondary variant with the awesome blue colorations on the shoulder pauldrons and the chest. I'm not positive we're getting that variant though because it's just on the poster and he's really, really, really tiny, but I'm gonna say that's confirmed. As for vehicles, we're getting the U-Wing for the Rebellion and the TIE Striker for the Empire. I don't know if these are gonna be pickups, where they're piloted by AI as soon as you grab the pickup, just like the Death Star DLC and the TIE Defenders and Y-Wings, or if they're going to be fully pilotable and controllable, or a third option still, if we're going to be able to control parts of them, like maybe the bombing portion of the TIE Striker and the gunnery ports of the U-Wing, kind of like we control the AT-AT, just we don't, you know, control where it goes. The heroes are going to be Jyn Erso, she rebels, and Director Orson Krennic, surrounded by two of his Death Trooper bodyguards. I hope the Death Trooper bodyguards are taller than the other Stormtroopers and Shore Troopers, because they are very tall in universe, and I'm really excited to see some awesome cape physics for Orson's legendary cape. I hope it gets wet in the water, just like the trailer. And that's the whole kit and caboodle. That's just about everything we know on Rogue One Scarif. But we do have some more Star Wars Battlefront news. On December 6th, we're also getting Star Wars Battlefront Rogue One X-Wing VR mission for PlayStation VR. It's free if you own Star Wars Battlefront, and it's really cool. It seems like it might be a loose tie-in to the game mode in Rogue One Scarif, because you're about to jump through hyperspace to carry out an important mission for the Rebellion, which might be the X-Wing assault on that big space tower we see in the trailer. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this news as much as I did, and if you want to see more Star Wars videos, Star Wars live streams, and anything and everything gaming, subscribe, leave a like, join our YouTube fam. We do stuff like this all the time, but until next time, may the Force be with you, always.